these next 4 weeks, we will be returning to the Gospel of Matthew, the primary gospel for this entire liturgical year. You remember that in the Christian church, the liturgical year begins with the first Sunday in Advent, which will come up this year, the first Sunday in December. And the last is usually at the end of November or just before the end of November. And during that time, the primary gospel is designated as one, and the year we've been in has been focused on Matthew. That doesn't mean we don't read other gospels, it doesn't mean we don't read other texts. But because we're going to focus for the next 4 weeks on the Gospel of Matthew, I want to remind you of a couple things about that gospel. One of them is that Matthew relates much of what is going on back to what is found in the Hebrew Scriptures, and wants to connect that line going forward to give justification for this new way that's evolving. The Gospel of Matthew is also written probably 50 to 60 years after Jesus died. So, as you know, there were no recordings. So Matthew is telling the story of Jesus' life and ministry from the perspective of his faith community, which is frankly what we all do. We don't always know that's what we're doing, but it's what we all do. And I don't say that to dismiss anything he's saying. I'm saying that to remind you to read it, to hear it, to explore it in that context. So this text opens, of course. Now Jesus is talking in this Gospel of Matthew at this point to the crowds and the disciples. Not to his enemies, but to the crowds and the disciples. And in this story, he is actually preparing to be out of the picture. If we are leading towards his death. At the time that this was written, the way, what it was referred to after Jesus died, the way, followers of the way of Jesus, many of them were housed within the synagogue. And so part of what Matthew is doing is saying, so I want you to know that our way is the better way. So he's saying these things like the scribes and the Pharisees sit on Moses' seat, and he's not taking issue with that. He's saying pay attention to what they say, just don't pay attention to what they do. Now we could go down several rabbit holes here. And you know what happens when you go down a rabbit hole? You go over this way, and then there's another one, and you go over that way, and you kind of get lost in the whole thing. A couple of those rabbit holes are that we can go, oh yeah, those scribes and Pharisees, we're so much better. I don't want you to go there. It's a waste of your time. We're not so much better. Scribes and Pharisees are doing what human beings have done from the beginning, and there were good things about the scribes and Pharisees. This is just a way of saying this way, the way Matthew is talking about is the right, is the better way. And so we pay attention to that. There's also this rabbit hole of if you choose the head of the table, you're going to get kicked down to the lower table. And we see this more than once in this gospel. And we can get lost in that too, right? It's kind of like, well, someone sits at the head table, right? And maybe it's going to be me, and maybe it's not. It doesn't mean hide your gifts under a bushel. It doesn't mean to pretend you can't sing alto. It means that you have gifts and you use them. And each of us has gifts, and we use them, and we don't use them to make us each better, right? Just because I'm Pastor Sally doesn't mean you couldn't preach next Sunday, Steve. Get ready. We use our gifts for the community, not to make ourselves on a pedestal. It doesn't mean it doesn't happen. But the point is for the community. This text boils down to a very simple message. We are brothers and sisters to each other. One of us isn't the mother or the father. One of us isn't the teacher or the director or the boss. We are brothers and sisters to each other. That's how we organize our lives in this faith community. And this is how we live. This is at the heart of the Gospel of Matthew. With everything else that's going on, it is a radically inclusive gospel. As long as we don't fall down those rabbit holes and get caught up in the arguments that we don't need. This is essentially the first anniversary of the Sunday preceding the last presidential election. This is the anniversary of the day I said to you, if you haven't voted, please do. If you know someone who hasn't voted, please invite them to vote. I didn't tell you how to vote because I wouldn't do that. And the following Sunday, we came together with Sing to Live, who will be with us next Sunday. And mostly we wept. Mary Smith this morning, in her column, talks about the shock and awe of what has happened and what continues to happen. One of the things she points to is the divisive nature of what is coming out of the White House. This gospel says you can't do that. This gospel says we are brothers and sisters, and we are called to treat each other with respect. The country has become more divided. We are invited to find a way to talk to each other. We are invited to find a way to speak to each other, to not become the target of the other, to not become attacked by the other, but to find those niches that open up, that allow us to experience the other as brother and sister. Mary Smead ends her column on a note of hope that partly because of what is going on in our nation's capital, in Springfield as well, people are standing up. People are standing with each other. People are claiming each other as brother and sister who might never have claimed each other before, because we need to do that. We need to be together, to have a presence, to speak what is true, to speak a word of love, to stand for justice, to stand for what is right, to do the right thing regardless of what other people think we should be doing. We don't decide what we're going to do based on somebody else's opinion. We decide what we're going to do based on what we believe. And if we believe in this Jesus we claim to follow, then we have to pay attention to what was written about him by those who are closer to the subject than we will ever be. And we look for the threads, the through lines that allow us to see, oh my God, we are called to love one another. We are called to be brothers and sisters. It fits so much with this focus we have this month about accessibility. It reminds us that just because we can walk up that aisle doesn't mean that everybody can walk up that aisle. Just because we can get through a door doesn't mean everyone can get through a door. And so as brothers and sisters, we care about that. We pay attention to that. And we make sure that a difference is made so that it's easier for everyone. I am so grateful for for the willingness of Wilbert and Joan to identify music that helps us celebrate the gifts of people who in other times might have been dismissed. You know, it wasn't that long ago that people who were born with disabilities were disappeared. A friend of mine, years ago, gave birth to a child. And that child was taken away. And she never saw that child again. She was young. She thought, I guess that's what they do. And a couple weeks later, she went back to the hospital and she said, you didn't let me see my baby. I want to see my baby. The baby was gone. We've heard those stories, right? Those stories about not valuing the life of someone because they're different. We are called to make space for each of us. The ways that I am different from Jane, you all seem to tolerate pretty well. But maybe there are some other differences that make us a little, I don't know, uncomfortable. As long as we are capable of being respectful to each other, caring for each other, loving each other, then we can be faith community. We can live this gospel. I see us working with that. I see us struggling with that. I see us living into it to the best of our ability. And we can never rest on what we have done. We always need to be aware of what more we can do. So that when anyone walks through that door, or through that one, but mostly through that one, they know that here they are part of the beloved community. They know that here they are indeed beloved. That each of us knows that. This text invites us to remember that we are brothers and sisters, one to the other. And to live our lives as if we believed it. What should we do? Love one another.